Dat mens toothbrand.
Zo maar wijd bro, die is toothbrandjes.
Maar intern. You're right, boy. You know what you're doing.
Oh, you check it, the stuff is in the right.
I'm done making jokes. Go and trail up, test me and again we let it rain. Please don't start us up, got that black and white, baby.
What's up guys, welcome back to another week's episode. In this week's episode we're going to be doing small little touches on the Mark 1, and then also the first thing that we're doing for Kirsten's car is spraying a calipers today. So Wade's here to help me. I prefer to take the entire caliper off, but Wade's done a few on car already, so he's gonna help me out with that, and we're gonna tackle that now first, and then we're gonna do the Mark 1. So Kirsten just recently had her wheels resprayed. There was some curb rash on that she had repaired, and today she wants us to do her brake calipers. So she went with a blue, the blue to go with the Ford sign with the Ford cap in the center. We got a metallic blue. It's not the same color as the cap, but it should give a nice contrast between the two, so we'll be using this. We're first gonna give it a clean with some brake cleaner and maybe a sand with sandpaper, and then just wrap everything up, cover all the area around with black bags, and then we can give it a coat. I think how many coats are gonna give it? About one or two? We'll see after the first coat how it looks, but probably two coats. If we can get away with one, we'll do one, and then obviously a clear coat as well. So let's get into that and then we can tackle the Mark 1. So we got the first wheel off. We're just gonna put some brake cleaner on. Got some brake cleaner over there. Gonna brake clean that, the way I brought this toothbrush with, just to wipe it down after we sprayed it. And then we might just give it a light sand.
Oh man's toothbrush. So my white bro, this toothbrush. White bro, this toothbrush, but are you just not my toothbrush?
Once we're done with that, we can cover everything up with the black bags and then give it a spray. Sandpaper.
Yeah, we need it.
I just removed the rest of the wheels to make it easy and go faster for us, but while I did that, Wade covered everything up in the front and it's ready for spraying. Got everything covered up in the surrounding areas just for overspray. We don't want overspray anywhere. Got everything covered here, the disc. We covered these boots as well, so we don't want to get spray on there. And then the caliper as well. Well, not the caliper, the brake pad, just the part of the pad. So we don't want spray on there. So we covered that up, covered the boots, gave it a sandpaper and brake cleaner, and now we can spray. We're gonna try one coat, see if it's good enough. If not, we'll do two coats with a clear coat as well. So this way is like a quick way to do it. It's not the preferred way. I'll actually leave a link in here for when I sprayed the Mark 1 calipers. I removed everything. The only issue with that is if you do it that way, you're gonna have to bleed the system, the brake system, replace the brake fluid. So it is a bit of a time consuming job. This is a quicker way, but I will leave a link for that to do the way with removing and then bleeding the brakes and all of that.
Yours, very bright.
We've got the first coat on. It actually looks very nice. I really like this color. Hopefully it looks nice with the Ford center cap of the wheel. Hopefully it has a nice contrast between the two, but I really like this color. That is one coat. We still want to give it another one. We've got Wade over there cleaning up the rear, and then we're going to spray that after we tape everything up, and then give a second coat on this one after that. There we go, we've got it complete. It looks really nice. It's very subtle, but it makes quite a big difference, and it goes really well with the white and the blue center cap on the wheel. I'll show you guys how it looks. We're just pulling it right here, but it actually came out really nice.
As you can see, it's very subtle, but it makes a nice difference. I'm actually really impressed with this color.
The lighting isn't the best, but you can see it really complements really well the white anthracite wheel, and then the center cap is blue, so it came out really nice. I think Kirsten will be happy. Now that that's done, we can tackle the Mark 1 quickly. And before we do that, I just want to say that this is not the preferable way. I don't suggest doing it, but if you don't have the tools to remove the caliper and you don't know how to bleed the brakes on your system of your car, this is one of the easiest ways to do it. So not what I suggest or recommend, but it is a way of doing it. So now we're just going to put the spacers on the rear, and then I want to get the spigots on the front spacers of the Mark 1 as well. I actually went out to get the spigots for the front because last week when we went out for that photo shoot, then when I went over 100, about 110 around there, the car would shake. And I did actually do alignment and the wheels were balanced. So my dad said he thinks it could be because of the spacers that it wasn't centralized. So that's why I went out to get the spigots, and then I also got the rear. The rear I'm gonna run 8mm, the front is 5mm, and then I also got extended nuts just for the safeness and for peace of mind for me driving. And I didn't want to race with that. There was Kilani, I think, last week and today, but I didn't want to race the car without the extended nuts. I was thinking of raising the front a little bit, but I think I'll enjoy it for a little bit more like this.
This is the rear spacers. This is the 8mm we got. And then I put the spigots in here already. The ones we have in front, when I got it from Wade, it didn't have that, so it wasn't centralized. So we're thinking that could cause the vibration on the steering. So I went out and got extra two for the front. And we've got 16 new extended nuts. So as you can see, there's no spigot on here, so there's a lot of play in here and it's very loose. So we were thinking that could have been the cause of that. Not 100% sure, but just to be certain, I'm gonna put it in here, the spigot, so it will be centralized properly. So you can see the difference in the size between the two. The one on the left is the front, which is a 5mm, and one on the right is the 8mm that I'll be using in the rear. And then here you can see the difference between the sizes of the bolts. Just that extra bit that will compensate for the 8mm.
A few inches later.
So unfortunately we ran into a bit of an issue. It seems like you're always running into issues, but I guess that's part of the game. That's what you have to prepare yourself for, and that's why I'm also adding it into the video, so you can see that everything doesn't always go according to plan. You're always going to run into issues, especially if you're working with aftermarket parts and stuff that's not supposed to be, or it's not originally from the car. So we ran into a bit of an issue with the spigot. It actually doesn't fit into the wheel.
If you look on the rear of the wheel over here, I've got the spigot and it doesn't fit flush in here, which pushes the wheel out even more further and also doesn't line everything up. So I'm not sure if I can get one that will fit in here, but this one certainly doesn't fit in, which is a bummer.
So I'm gonna call it here for the day. Trying it out to where I bought it. I'm gonna go there tomorrow morning early. Hopefully they can sort me out with the right ones. If not, then I'll just put it back on, leave it as is for now till I can get the proper spigots or the proper spaces for Mark 1 that fits exactly how it needs to. I didn't manage to get what I went to look for yesterday, so hopefully I can sort that out in this week. If any of you guys have any recommendations or know I can get proper spaces for Mark 1s, please let me know down in the comments. And then I was also going to fit the lower control arm brace, but I will leave that for when I sort out the spaces Oh yes, and there's just one more thing I want to show you before I leave.
I know this is very sought after in the Mark 1 community, so if anybody's interested, I've got a velocity steering for sale. Only issue is it doesn't have the center cap, but other than that, it is in extremely good condition. It's basically brand new. You can see how it looks over here, and at the back, very good condition. So
if you are interested in it, you can just pop me a DM on Instagram and we can negotiate the price. Like I said, it is missing the center cap, but it is in extremely good condition. So yeah, if you are interested, just drop me a DM. But I think that's where I'm gonna call it for this week's episode. I apologize for it wasn't the most interesting episode, but thank you for you guys who stayed so far and who stayed till the end. I really appreciate you guys. Hopefully we'll bring you something a bit more interesting and better in next week's episode. So yeah, that's it for this week's episode, and I will see you guys next week. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and continue elevating. Peace. Back on deck on my fly. Back. Really on